It's supposed to be the merriest season of the year, but some people just can't seem to get into the Christmas spirit, and researchers say that you can thank your brain for that.
Scientists are calling it the Bah Humbug Syndrome, and Dr. Devi, an associate professor at NYU School of Medicine, is here to walk us through it. So, Dr. Devi, you know, I think a lot of people might be saying, could this apply to me? Because this time of year, for some people, is really tough. Can you explain, first of all, what researchers found in this study?
Well, they did a small study, so they looked at several people, and they tried to see, you know, some people don't really feel a lot of positive feelings around this time, and other people do. So they tried to compare them using fMRI. Now, this is a test that basically looks at blood flow to the brain, so which parts of the brain light up. And then they compared the two because really the difference is in which parts of the brain light up and the ones that are maybe not as happy or don't have as much of the holiday spirit. Now, they found some differences, but I don't really know if this is a medical problem per se, right? Because people have different ideas when they look at things that are related to the holidays or they hear different things. I mean, they're bringing their past experiences to it, right?
Well, I think I have a little bit of this. It's a social problem if it's not a medical problem, because I'm not into Christmas carols. They sort of bring me down. But I like Christmas and I like being with my family, so I kind of got it. You know what I mean? I understood it.
Sure.
fMRIs, what are they used for other than to determine whether or not you have humbug syndrome?
Well, we use them to look at blood flow. So, for example, if there's some task that you're doing, let's say after strokes or after brain injuries, they're trying to look to see what parts of the brain control different movements or different activities. So you can actually localize those types of things. But with emotions, it's a lot harder because, like you said, you know, let's say, for example, Christmas carols. Like, if you were to listen to those and have parts of your brain light up, I mean, it might be because you're filled with a holiday spirit or not. It might be because you're actually listening to the music. If you're a musician, different parts might light up. And then there might also be other types of things. Like, you're thinking about, oh, is this person, you know, fundraising or whatever else? So you might have a lot of different things that are going into that. So fMRI is really hard to use for something like that. It's a little bit better for something more medical or motor.
Such Elaine's would light up, and mine would not. Elaine would be thinking, oh, this is a great time of the year. I've heard this song 25 times already. Enough.
Yeah, I think we're like opposite on that. But also, it's important to point out only 26 people in this study.
Exactly. It's a very small study, and I don't know if fMRI is the best thing to look at this. And plus, I mean, people really do have more, you know, a higher incidence of depression at times during the holidays. So people do have problems, but I don't know that Bah Humbug Syndrome is really a medical problem. You know, people have different ideas about the holidays.